What happened to her?
Well, we had a good friendship going. I had a good friendship going with Eva. Early in the morning, she used to wake me up. She used to lean over, and she used to tickle my hair and my ear, and that was our friendly togetherness. And one morning, they took her, and they took me as well, and they brought me back, and I were practically unconscious. I don't know what they did to me, but I had all kinds of stitches and bandages in my body. Obviously, some kind of operations they were doing. And the next morning, I were hoping that Eve will wake me up. As always, she used to bend over and tickle me. And she used to say, "Wake up, you lazy boy." And that morning she didn't do that. And I were very weak, and I couldn't look up the top bunk. So I asked one of the Jewish lady who were looking after us, I asked her, "Where is Eve?" And she said that Eve did not came back from Birkenau, from that hospital. And so I thought maybe she'd be coming back later. Unfortunately, she never did. And I asked the lady that, "Where is Eve?" And she said, "Do not wait for her. She won't be coming back." So I assumed that she is dead. And I cried a lot. I missed her very much. And what's happened sometimes that they took some of the children, 5-6 of them, and only half of them come back. The experiments went wrong. And when they died, they took them straight into the place where they burned their body. And you never see them again. And that's what's happened to Eva. And I wish I would have died as well. I missed her so much. That was my only very close friend.
What did you do during the day?
Well, during the day, just lying down and didn't do really anything, except if you had to go to a toilet, you asked the person who were looking after us, and they usually, if you're strong enough to able to walk, you could get out of bed and walk to it. They had one toilet, and if you was weak, then you had a kind of a plate that you can do your business. Nothing much really you could do. You eaten what they're giving you, and you drink what they're giving you, and more or less waiting for the next day that it might get better.
Did you have a tattoo on your arm?
When I arrived to Auschwitz, approximately 3 days later, they're giving us the tattoo. They take into a room where they actually cut our hair down. They took our hair, they shaved our head, and they exchanged our clothes. That's when we got that rough clothes, like blankets, made out of blankets. And we had to sit down in a corner, and that's where they had this this electronic gear where they put us a tattoo on our arms.
I understand that Steiner is not your real, not your original name.
Yes.
Can you tell us where it came from?
Yes. It's a little bit long story, but if you've got time, I will tell you. When my father is a German, and he born in Hamburg, and he went to Hamburg University and became an engineer degree. And the factory he worked in, they were manufacturing medical equipment. And they sold a large container load of equipment, medical equipment, into Hungary. And every time this factory in Hamburg shifted the equipment, they always send an engineer with the shipment to demonstrate how the equipment works, x-rays, hydraulic tables, or, you know, dentist equipment, all this type of equipment. And so my father came to Hungary with all this equipment, and he was demonstrating it in a hospital to the staff, who amongst that staff were my mother, who a doctor. She was also introduced to my father, and my father were demonstrating all this medical equipment. And that's how he met my mother. And they became friends, and eventually the friendship grew much closer than a friendship, and they decided that they're going to get married. In the meantime, the war were getting nastier and got worldwide spread. Germany attacked Russia and taking all the northern countries, invaded, France invaded Belgium, Normandy, Holland, and so the war were very bad, and my grandparents from Hamburg told my father, do not come home because the Germans are taking all the Jews. So my father's name was, at the time, is Meyer. His surname was Meyer, but that's a Jewish name. And he thought that if he changed his name to something like more German-like, they might escape being taken. So my father changed his name from Meyer into Schneider. And in between that time, my mother got pregnant from my father, they got married. And when I born as Schneider. And so I live my life as William Schneider, and hoping that the Nazis will not pick me up. Unfortunately, that's backfired because they took my father first. One night they turned up, middle of the night took my father. 2 weeks later, my mother took me into a Catholic boarding school, hoping that the Germans won't be able to find me. However, the Germans came one night to the Catholic convent, and they made an announcement, all Jewish children step forward. So I wasn't going to step forward, but one of the nuns came over and grabbed my ear, and he said, come on, you little Jew, step forward, you heard that they want you. And then, of course, my very good friend Eve, that's where I met Eve, actually. We were holding hands, so when I stepped forward, I dragged her forward with me. I shouldn't have done it, but we were good friends, and she came as well. And eventually, they took us into a railway wagon that night, and 2 days later, we arrived at Auschwitz. And we ended up in our same room and in the same bunk. She was in a top bunk, I was in a middle bunk. And one night, I was in Auschwitz, in Birkenau. I was experimented on it, and after they cutting me up, and I was stitched up, but I was very weak and wasn't really very well. But in the morning, the German officer came with two other attendants, and they touched me with the bamboo stick, and they told me to get up. They want to take me to a laboratory, to the Birkenau. But I was very slow. I wasn't well, and I was very slow. So he started to hit me with that bamboo stick of his, and he was saying, "Hurry up, hurry up." And the lady who was looking after us, her name was Steiner. So Mrs. Steiner came over and grabbed the bamboo stick from the German officer and said to him, "Please don't hit him, he's not well. He was medicated all night and he's a little bit slow, he's not well." The German officer pulled out his gun and shot her dead, saying at the same time, "How dare you touch me, a Wehrmacht officer." Anyway, a minute later, the two other companions he had, they went outside, they come back with a two-wheeler wagon and put her into that wagon and wheeled her out. Now, time has gone, and after the war, when Russian liberated Auschwitz, and I managed to get better, and I got back to Hungary, to my parents, united. That was quite a few years later. And then we had a Hungarian Revolution breakout in Hungary, and I were against the Russians, and I were a university student at the time, and I were shooting him with some of my friends. And eventually, I had to come to New Zealand because the Germans were collecting, not the German, I beg your pardon, the Russians, secret service, and the Russian soldiers were collecting all the people who were involved with the revolution. And then, of course, the university students were in front line, so I had to leave Hungary, and then I come to New Zealand. When I arrived in New Zealand, the Jewish community looked after me. They bought the Hungarian rabbi, Rabbi Korda, and an English rabbi, Rabbi Este. They bought me my very first saxophone. And me unable to speak English, I couldn't get a job. So with the saxophone, I got a job just like that. And I never looked back. I earned more money than a rabbi. I earned good money. And however, years gone, and time to time, I got very upset, and I got very... It took me some time to recover to leaving my parents again and leaving my home, living in a new country. I got very emotional. And one night, at the synagogue, we were talking about this with Rabbi Korda, and I decided that honor of Mrs. Steiner, who died for me by stopping the German to hitting me with his bamboo stick, he died for me. I decided that for her honor, I changed my name into Steiner. I didn't really like Schneider, because Schneider is not a Hungarian name, it's a German name, and I didn't really like it. And I couldn't really understand why my father from Meyer changed into Schneider, and then I inherited Schneider. But then I realized that he had the same emotion and the same idea that changing his name from the Jewish name into a German name so he could escape the Nazis to pick him up. It didn't work, of course. But at that time, that's what he thought that he will do. So years later, I decided that to honor Mrs. Steiner, that's the only thing I could do, is change my name into Steiner, because I didn't really like Schneider either. So that's the reason I changed my name.
Yeah. Thank you. Were you scared?
Well, yes, yes, I must admit, I did not felt very relaxed and comfortable. I did scared.
Did you miss your family?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. I miss my family, and in New Zealand, the New Zealand was very good to me. I managed to get a good job. I earned very good living with a saxophone, and then when I got married, I joined Air New Zealand, and I were flying around the world, and I visited my parents. 9 times I went home and visited my parents, and every time I went home, I got them their favorite cigars and their favorite brandy. So I looked after them, and now that they're gone, I miss them.
Were you tired during the day?
Could you repeat this again?
Yeah. Were you tired during the day?
At that time?
In the camp.
Oh, in a camp, in Auschwitz. Well, I very honestly, I don't sort of remember that. All I remember that every second or third day, they collected me and took me into Birkenau to that hospital where they were cutting people up and cutting me up and taking all kinds of chopped up organs and giving us all kinds of medication. And I don't think it was tiredness. I think it was illness, sickness, not feeling well. You know, half a time not really with it. Half a time were nauseated, dizzy, not. No, that's the thing I remember.
Thank you. Were you always kept in Auschwitz?
Always got...
kept at Auschwitz?
Yes, yes. Always stayed in Auschwitz until the Russians arrived and liberated the camp. And 2 days later, once the Russians gone, the big wave, they just come, looked, and they went. 2 days later, the British arrived with Americans' allies, and they were well equipped. For 2 days while we were alone, after the Russians came, the Germans were running away and left behind all the sick and everybody they left behind. They buggered off. And for 2 days we had no food, no drinks, no nothing. And 2 days later, when the British arrived, they were well equipped. They had ambulances and large buses were converted into ambulance and beds in it, and picked up all the sick children, particularly one who was in my ward. All the sick children were put into these buses, and we were driven into Denmark. Denmark were well equipped. They had a great big sanatorium with hundreds of beds and sick people, and we had doctors and they were looked after us. So the British were absolutely fantastic, decent, lovely people.
How many hours did you get of sleep?
I think almost all the time I were half asleep. not quite distinguish when you're awake or when you're asleep. You know, so we had so much, I had so much medication, injections and pills and things that a half a time I don't remember that I were awake or I were asleep. It was one of those times that just wasn't with it.